Back when we were doing the roof last summer, we ordered some new scaffold boards, but because of a mix-up at the sawmill, they cut them in oak rather than pine, and that means they're a lot heavier, so we've quickly given up using them as scaffolding. But because they've been drying and seasoning now for 9 months, we can use them to make this door. But obviously during that time, they've moved and bowed and twisted quite a lot. So they're gonna need a bit of processing before they're in a state where we can join them together. What I'm actually doing here is trying to create a perfectly flat surface on each of the boards. And this is a good example of a board that's twisted and bowed, and you can see where the surfacer has taken some wood off and where it hasn't. And that just shows you that it's kind of doing this. And the next step is trying to get a 90 degree edge. So the third step is to run them through the table saw using this square edge against the fence and taking as little as possible off this side so we can maximize the width of each board. Thank you. So the final step is to send them through the thicknesser, which takes a tiny amount of wood off each time you go through and should leave us with a perfectly square board around about 25 mil thick. Bloody big door. Thank you. So you may have noticed that one of these boards has a really horrible knot in. So hopefully when we get this brace in, we're going to take a little notch out of the ledge and that should cover up the knot. So it's going to come down 35 mil at 90 degrees to the brace. When the weight of the door is falling down onto the brace, it's going to go directly into this corner here, which should be really strong because it's against the hinge and the door frame. The problem is with this is that any inaccuracies or just small errors are going to be really visible. I just wanted to say that I'm fully aware how ridiculous this is. The TS55 is actually getting sharpened right now, so this is the only way that I can do it.
Cool, came back.
So as you saw, I botched this car. And because this is going to be right in the eye line, we've decided to cut another board to shape, which is going to replace that ledge. And the cut on the middle ledge wasn't so bad, and because that's going to be against the hinge side, so we're going to fill that in with some glue and some sawdust, so that will be hardly noticeable.
A few moments later.